Charlie and I had both agreed we needed to develop some kind of niche for me to have any chance of pushing the boundaries that would single me out. So this was right prior to a huge round of press we had lined up to more or less introduce me as the new starlet in the world of porn. And the timing was perfect for what we had in mind. Basically, we came up with a strategy wherein whenever an interviewer would ask me a question about my future plans, I would bring it up, the fact that I was going to top the girl who had had 251 guys in 24 hours. So surely enough, starting with Excitement Magazine in Florida and then all these other publications, I kept plugging it and plugging it to the point where we are actually creating a buzz out of nothing. Then to elevate things even further, Charlie arranged for me to go on Jerry Springer for a second time, and I announced in the show I was going to do 300 guys in 24 hours. So next we brought the idea to John T-Bone at Metro, and they jumped all over it. And Metro had basically signed me to do 12 movies, so we collectively came up with a strategy wherein we'd build up to do the main event, so to speak, later in the year. As we began shaping the direction of my career, add to the extreme nature of my brand of porn, Charlie and John T-Bone both wanted to capitalize on the fact that I was this. As they put it, beautiful and exotic-looking girl doing hardcore, and at the time, there wasn't any of that going on. I had an instant niche we could build off of, because we were almost inventing the market as we went along. For instance, the fact that I lost my anal virginity on camera in my next movie lent kind of a purity to my image as we began building it in the press. I made it sound sexy in print, but in truth, I'd been scared shitless. Pardon the pun. So going forth, that became a signature of my scenes. The fact that I did anal, hardcore, whatever would push the boundaries a little at a time. By our estimation, in doing so, those boundaries were bound to snap and open a whole new brand of porn when I finally got to World's Greatest Gangbang 2, as John officially branded it. We looked at it in a sexual metaphor, like a buildup leading to a massive climax over 24 hours that would change the modern landscape of porn forever after.